Find cube root of 9261. To find the cube root, first we should do the prime factorization of it. So let us do. So 9261. Okay, Seaman. For this number, last digit is 1, which is not even. So this is not divisible by 2. Next prime number 3. To check divisibility by 3, for that we should add the digits. That is 9 plus 2 plus 6 plus 1. We get 18. Is 18 divisible by 3? Yes. So this number also divisible by 3, and we take 3 here. Now first number is 9. When do we get 9 in 3 table? 3, 3 is 9. Next number is 2. 2 smaller than 3, so we should take 2 numbers, that is 26. Whenever you are taking 2 numbers, compulsory you should put 0. It is a rule. Remember that. Whenever you take 2 numbers, compulsory you put 0. Okay, next. Here we have 26. Now a number close to 26 in 3 table is 3 8s 24. 26 minus 24 is 2, 2 carried forward making it 21. Now when do we get 21 in 3 table? 3 7s 21. Next. For this number, last digit is 7, which is not even, so this is not divisible by 2. Now to check divisibility by 3, for that we should add the digits. That is 3 plus 0 plus 8 plus 7. We get 18. Is 18 divisible by 3? Yes. So this number also divisible by 3, and we take 3 here. Now first number is 3. When do we get 3 in 3 table? 3 1's 3. This 0 as it is carried down. Here we have 8. Now a number close to 8 in 3 table is 3 2 6. 8 minus 6 is 2, 2 carried forward making it 27. Now when do we get 27 in 3 table? 3 9 is 27. Now for this number, last digit is 9, not even, so this is not divisible by 2. To check divisibility by 3, you add the digits. That is 1 plus 0 plus 2 plus 9. We get 12. 12 divisible by 3? Yes. So this number also divisible by 3, and we take 3 here. Now first number is 1. 1 smaller than 3, so we should take 2 numbers, that is 10. Whenever you take 2 numbers, compulsory you should put 0. But at the start, whether you put 0 or not, it does not make any difference. So I am not placing 0 at the start. In between, if you are taking 2 numbers, then 0 is compulsory. At the start, whether you write or you don't write, it does not make any difference. So I am not writing it. Now 10. A number close to 10 in 3 table is 3, 3 is 9. 10 minus 9 is 1, 1 carried forward making it 12. When do we get 12 in 3 table? 3, 4 is 12. Next number is 9. When do we get 9 in 3 table? 3, 3 is 9. Now, for this number, last digit is 3, which is not even, so this is not divisible by 2. Next to prime number is 3. To check divisibility by 3, we add the digits. That is 3 plus 4 plus 3. We get 10. 10 not divisible by 3, so this number also not divisible by 3. Next prime number is 5. To check divisibility by 5, for that the last digit is neither 0 nor 5, so this is not divisible by 5. Next prime number is 7. To check divisibility by 7, we do this. 343 by 7. A number close to 34 in 7 table is 7 4 is 28. 34 minus 28 is 6, 6 carried forward making it 63. 7 9s 63. So this is divisible by 7. So we take 7 here. and here we write 49. Now 49 is nothing but 7 sevens 49. Now 7 is a prime number, so we take 7 and 1. So now 9261 is equal to the product of these numbers. Okay, that is 3 into 3 into 3 into 7 into 7 into 7. Okay, here we have to find the cube root. So you take cube root on both sides. Next, we have a property for the cube root. A number is present 3 times inside the cube root, it will come out and it should be written only once. So here we have the number 3 present 3 times. So this, it will come out and you will be writing it only once. Next number is 7. 7 is present 3 times inside the cube root. So it will come out and it will be written only once. No more numbers are left. So we have 3 into 7, that is 21. And on this side, cube root 9261. So cube root of this is 21. This is our answer. Am I clear?